Overthinking is nothing but confusion. Thoughts and thoughts fighting against each other, clashing against each other, all of them asking for your attention. Thousands of thoughts pulling you into 1,000 different directions. It is a miracle how you keep yourself together. Somehow you manage to keep yourself together. You are not really in control of yourself because the mind is in control of you. It is only a facade of trying to keep yourself together. Behind it is a civil war, a continuous civil war. Thoughts fighting with each other, thoughts wanting you to fulfill them. It is a great confusion, negative thoughts, overthinking. But if you are aware that it is because of your mind that all this overthinking, negative thoughts are happening, and if you do not get identified with your mind, then you will not get bothered. Not getting identified with the mind means you understand that you are not the mind. You are not these thoughts. You are something much more greater. This mind is nothing but an accumulation of thoughts. These thoughts are nothing but past knowledge. You are not these thoughts. You are not this mind. You are something much more greater. If you get identified with the mind, then you are in for big trouble. But if you are not identified with the mind, then nothing can bother you anymore. This overthinking, confused mind, these negative thoughts will lose its power. Once you understand how to be aware of these negative thoughts, how to be aware of your mind, being aware means just being an observer, just being a watcher of your thoughts, not involving in them much. Just watching them come, watching them go. It is beautiful. And once you are able to become an observer, then these negative thoughts, this overthinking mind dies, and you are born as a meditator. That birth is enlightenment. That birth, for the first time, brings you to the land of peace, paradise. It brings you to the land of bliss, benediction. Otherwise, you remain in hell. But if you resolve, you decide, if you choose to become an observer, then right now you can take a jump, a leap from hell to heaven. It is up to you. You can choose hell or you can choose heaven. Hell or heaven is not something you die and go to. They both are right here. Hell is cheap, but heaven needs a bit of your effort. Hell means you can remain unaware. You can be controlled by your thoughts. You will be miserable by your overthinking and negative thoughts. Heaven means you have to rise above yourself. You have to transcend. This transcendence, this is liberation, moksha. This is nirvana. This is nothing but the death of negativity in your life and the birth of God. A new man is needed on earth. The old is rotten and finished. It has no future. It cannot survive. Unless a new man is born, humanity is doomed. It depends on how committed, how involved you become towards working on your own transcendence. It is in your hands to end all your misery and live in bliss forever.